Welcome to our second video in our GRE test prep session. If you haven't checked out our first video on GRE words, you can click here and check it out now. Today, I will be taking you through GRE Quants, a section which can be a walk in the park for certain engineers and a challenging but rewarding experience for those who are still haunted by the word math. At the risk of repeating myself, to score a 320 plus score in GRE, it is imperative that you score well in both the sections. If you are not as confident in your GRE verbal score, scoring a 165 plus in quants becomes absolutely necessary. Not only that, competitive programs prefer students who have a top score in their GRE quant section. Don't believe me? Hear it from a guy who scored 340 on 340 in GRE and went live on our channel recently here. But don't worry, with a smart preparation strategy and some practice, you will be able to ace this section with flying colors. So how to make that feat possible? Let's take it step by step and understand what the GRE Quant section is all about. GRE Quants will primarily test your problem solving and analytical skills. There will be two sections in the exam with 20 questions each, and you will have about half an hour to solve each of these sections. Questions are asked from concepts most of us have studied in school: algebra, arithmetic, data analysis, and geometry. Quant questions are asked in four formats: multiple choice questions, multiple choice questions with multiple answers, numeric entry questions, and comparison questions. Multiple choice questions, or simply MCQs, are a problem type that most of us are familiar with. The question would be followed by five options, one of which would be the correct answer. To score well in these kind of problems, number one, make sure you read the question thoroughly and understand it. Pay close attention to words like not, except, at most, etc. You will have less than 1.5 minutes for each quant's question, so making silly mistakes can be very easy. Try and estimate your answers to bypass lengthy calculations. If the options are spaced out, close estimations can help you save a lot of time. Number three, you can also try to plug in the options and see which of them satisfies the equation. Your focus should be on solving the problems as fast as possible without making an error. Next up are multiple choice, multiple answer questions. There is no partial marking and you will have to select all of the options that satisfy a particular criteria given in the question to score. Here are some tips to solve these problems. The process of elimination can prove to be a useful ally in these kind of questions. Quickly eliminate the options that do not fit the criteria and work with the rest of them. Some questions will mention the number of answers needed. For example, there can be a question that says select the two options that together have, and so on. Make sure you follow the instructions carefully without panicking. GRE Quants also have numeric entry questions. In these, you have to enter your response into a box. They are essentially free response questions where there are no options of answers to select from. To score well in this section, be very careful of the formats and units. For example, there can be a specific question that wants answers in meters or millimeters. Make sure you're extra careful with this because you don't want to spend a minute and a half on solving a question and just get it wrong because of haste. Finally, we come to comparison questions where you need to determine the relationship between quantities and pick the right answer from a set of four options. Two simple tips to do well in this section are: simplify the problem. For example, if you're trying to compare two algebraic expressions, make sure you cancel out terms, factorize, subtract, or add. Number two, fill in random values to check which quantity is correct. While this method can work in certain situations, it's not always recommended. Now that you know the different kind of questions that will be waiting to test you on the GRE, how should you start preparing for it? Number one, make a study plan. GRE Quant syllabus can look a little daunting at first, especially if you're a working professional with only a few hours every day for preparation. A well-designed study plan can be very useful for such aspirants. Taking some time out to design a study plan for yourself can help you in two ways. One, it helps you break down the big syllabus into small, manageable chunks and keeps your preparation on track. And two, it gives you flexibility to spend more or less time on certain topics. For example, if you find yourself struggling with geometry problems, you can allocate more time for those and complete the rest of the topics in lesser time. How do you find which topics you're strong at? Take multiple timed mock tests. It is advised to start your preparation by taking a GRE diagnostic test. Taking a diagnostic test will help you familiarize yourself with the GRE pattern, understand your strengths and weaknesses, and plan your preparation accordingly. You can take a quick diagnostic test now by heading over to the Yocket Prep website. Yocket Prep is a free test prep platform where you can take full diagnostic tests for the GRE or mini GRE quiz. You will also get a detailed analysis of your performance after the test. Check it out for yourself by clicking the link in the description. Also, taking multiple mock tests will help you understand if you are moving towards your target GRE score. You'll get accustomed to the clock pressure and become more confident with each mock test that you take. Number 3. Maintain a notebook. Having a notebook or a formula book near you when you're trying to revise a topic quickly can be very helpful. Note down important formulae and observations along with tough problems that you have trouble solving. Going through your notebook is so much easier than searching for it again and again on the internet. While it may take some time and effort to maintain your notebook, it will definitely be helpful in the long run. Number 4. Join study groups. This is not school study groups where there's more snacks and chatting than studying. I'm talking about groups on WhatsApp, Telegram, and Facebook where ambitious students are actively engaging with each other. Participants often share tough problems and their solutions on these groups. This will not only help you learn different ways to solve a particular problem, but also make sure you are motivated to keep practicing at a steady pace. Well, that is it for this video. Do let me know if you found this video helpful. Hit the like button and share it with your friends who want to get over the hurdle of GRE. Make sure to drop your queries in the comment section. Our experts will get back to you. Before you go, take a moment to check out our channel for more valuable information. Our Yocket Connect series, where Yocket aspirants who made it share their success stories, tips and experiences. Many expert interviews, tutorials and live streams outlining the nitty-gritties of everything study abroad. Next video dropping soon. Until then, stay tuned. Good luck, aspirants.